Hey guys, I am the Comics Kid 2099, and I wanted to talk to you guys about a graphic novel that I recently finished reading. This graphic novel is called Final Crisis: Legion of Three Worlds. It collects a 5-issue miniseries from DC Comics that came out around 2008. It is written by Geoff Johns and drawn by George Perez. And I'm going to start this review by talking about some of the things that I liked about this book. Number one, George Perez's art is awesome. I've always been a fan of his art ever since I started reading Teen Titans comics in high school, and he has not missed a step since then. I really think that his art is still top-notch, and if you want a great artist to draw thousands of superheroes, George Perez is the artist that you're going to want to go to. Another thing that I liked, it's really nice to see some of the past versions of the Legion that I didn't think I would ever see again. That's something that I talked about a few months ago when I did a rant on the Legion of Superheroes, is that ever since 1994, we've had three versions of the Legion of Superheroes, and it can get a little confusing. And one problem with this is that if you're a big fan of, say, the three-boot version of the team, like I am, and then that version is seemingly erased, and then you see the original version back again, you're probably going to think that you're never going to see the three-boot version again. And this is a nice bone to throw to fans of previous versions of the team who get to see those versions in action, if briefly. The conceit of this book is that every time the Legion reboots, the new version doesn't completely supplant the previous version, but instead, the previous version just takes place on an alternate Earth. And I will get to that in a minute, but this is nice in that it allows us to revisit those versions if we are fans of those versions, which I am at least somewhat a fan of all of the versions of the Legion. So this was a nice little chance to see that in action for myself. The other final thing that I wanted to say that I really liked about this book, I like that we get to see some of the Legionnaires from past versions of the team join the air quotes current team. While I haven't read much of the Legion stuff after this story, I am glad that Johns was able to find a way to bring over some of the characters from previous versions who don't exist in this version without resorting to another reboot. I would be talking about Gates, who is a teleporter, and XS, who is a speedster. Both of those characters were from the first reboot after Zero Hour: A Crisis in Time, and they did not have counterparts in any of the other two versions. So it was really nice that we got to see those guys jump over to this version of the team, and then if and when the Legion has its own title again, we can see these guys again without having duplicates running around. For example, we're not seeing another version of Lightning Lad jump over to this team. We're seeing more or less new characters that don't exist in this team, and that is a fresh opportunity for new stories when you add new characters to the team. In theory, you could tell new stories here. For example, Gates might constantly talk about the previous Legion that he was a part of and how Lightning Lad acts really different here than he did in that previous team. I don't know if this opportunity was seized after this story or not, but the chance to do those kinds of stories was definitely planted here, and I really like that. The rest of what I have to say here is more or less bad things that I did not really care about with this story. For one, this story is plainly marked as a tie-in to Final Crisis when it clearly has absolutely nothing to do with that story. Nothing about Darkseid taking over Earth, nothing about evil vampire monitors trying to do something. This might as well have been just an ordinary Legion of Superheroes story. And there's nothing wrong with doing an ordinary Legion of Superheroes story. I just don't understand why someone, somewhere, thought it would be a good idea to tie this story to Final Crisis when it really doesn't have anything to do with that story at all. I mentioned that I liked that we got to see the other versions of the Legion in this story, and that it had something that I didn't like going on as well. Even though everyone has the comfort of knowing that their favorite versions of the Legion still exist on some parallel world, it still doesn't take away the sting of seeing those versions get replaced with the air quotes original Legion. We will still only ever see one version of the Legion at a time. If my favorite version of the team is the three-boot version, knowing they exist on a parallel Earth does not make things easier when I don't get to read about them ever again. Something else I really didn't like about this book is the villain, specifically Superboy Prime. Superboy Prime is just a whiny fanboy, and nobody wants to read about a whiny fanboy. If you spend as much time on the internet as I do, or even half as much time on the internet as I do, you've probably encountered whiny fanboys who whine about stuff that you just don't care about. And if you have, then you really don't like interacting with these people, and you certainly don't want to read a book about these people. I'd be okay with Superboy Prime's motivation being, no, this world is not right, this isn't what I sacrificed my life to save, I'm going to make everything right again. Which, if I'm not mistaken, is more or less his motivation that he shared with Alexander Luthor in Infinite Crisis. But here, he's just a whiny brat with the powers of Superman. His dialogue is even as bad as, "You're stupid! Stop! I don't like the dark! I'm gonna go punch your girlfriend in the face!" I guess this is Geoff Johns' cathartic way of destroying everyone who has never liked his work, but this doesn't make his work any better. It just comes off as kinda bad. Another thing I did not like about this book is the motivations of the bad guys. The motivations are virtually non-existent. Racist Justice League members from Superman and the Legion of Superheroes are working with aliens for the very simplistic reason of, we hate the Legion, so we're going to work together. The only real reason that these guys are working with the Legion of Supervillains and why Mordru is working with the team is that Geoff Johns thought that it would be cool to do his own version of the Legion of Superheroes, but bigger and badder, even when it doesn't really make sense on a character level. This book also sees the resurrection of Connor Kent as Superboy and Bart Allen as Kid Flash. While I don't really like killing off a character just to bring them back like 2 years later, I understand that it's inevitable in this day and age. But if you're going to kill off two Teen Titans characters and then you plan to resurrect them, shouldn't you at least bring them back in the Teen Titans comic book? Just a thought. And the final thing that I did not really care for, even though this story plainly states that the Time Trapper's identity could change again as time moves on, I did not care for the reveal that Superboy Prime grows up to become the Time Trapper, as I really don't think the Time Trapper's actions in the past match up with what Superboy Prime would do. This all goes back to characters having little to no motivation, or their motivations changing on a dime. Overall, I know this is going to sound extremely harsh, but this feels a lot like a little kid playing with toys. What if we used a gigantic team of villains, but there are even more of them? Which, as I said, this doesn't work when several of the people that you're adding to this team have drastically different character motivations. Or, instead of one Legion, there's three. Throwing every toy that you have into the game that you're playing does not make the story better. It really just makes things even more complicated and confusing, which is something that the Legion of Superheroes definitely does not need. There are many times when I was reading this that I had no idea what was being referenced, and I'm fairly well versed in the characters of the DC Universe. Imagine how a fairly new reader would feel trying to read this. And I don't want to hear anyone say that I'm just being a hater toward Geoff Johns. While it's true I usually don't like his work, I loved Superman and the Legion of Superheroes, so I was actually expecting more out of this than I usually expect from Johns. Anyway, that's about all I have to say here, guys. I hope that you enjoyed this book more than I did, and I hope you enjoyed this review. If you did, be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I will be back tomorrow for some other kind of video. Until then, have a great day.